Hi guys, and welcome to our next video. And this video is going to be all about session hijacking. Wow, the tools we can use to actually manipulate the users into actually hijack their session IDs. This video is going to explain much information. It is going to be like explaining new tools. So sit back and enjoy. So here we're using Kali for that attack, of course. You can use other distros. That tools are actually Linux based, so they run on any Linux there, so you don't have to worry about it. So most of the tools like Hamster we have pre-installed in Kali. If you do not have pre-installed, just run that sudo get install Hamster. I'm going to show it in future. So now we are going to install one tool called Ferret, and this tool is actually stands for collecting cookies. These two actually see all the traffic that passes through us, and we spoken that we have to be man in the middle before we actually use and try to actually session hijack. We need to be man in the middle, so all the requests with all the cookies come through us. And now with that tool, we are actually capturing all the cookies that fly through us. So that's why that's the point of becoming man in the middle. So in order to install that tool, just open a terminal and go for install apt-get install ferret sidejack. So this is the name of the tool. As you can see, I have the latest version, but it's okay if you actually wait a little bit, click yes, and it's going to be installed. So click clear now, just go clear that window. And now we are ready to enter the attack. We can even see if do we have hamster. So apt-cache search hamster, and this is the way you can actually search for programs in Linux. So click enter, and we see that we have hamster hijack sidejack. Sorry, if you do not have that, install hamster sidejack. It's going to install all of its dependencies too. So now we have the bot tools up and running, so clear that again. And now it's actually time to begin and start the attack. So the first thing we have to do is to actually become main in the middle, and you know that is done by our spoof. We're gonna do it the manual way, but it does not really matter what way you are using that. You can use better cap, you can use header cap, you can use manual way to actually become man in the middle. It do not matter, but now I'm gonna use the manual way since it's the more understandable and more clear, and it's the more fundamental. So since you are going to need a lot of terminals here, I prefer to use tmux, and the tmux is just, as I said before, virtual emulator, so we can run multiple virtual terminal consoles here, so it's really useful. And the shift key is Control B, so Control B is the key, and therefore you can start using a create for C and just, for example, running back and forth with 0 and 1. So 0, 1, Control B, 0. This is really easy to, you can start with apt-get install tmux. It's really amazing. So I personally prefer that. And now here with Control B and comma, we're actually going to rename that window. So our spoof 1, and here go to here and rename it again. So our spoof 2. Okay, so go back to 0, and therefore type. So now we type here our spoof. We know this, the IP of our gateway. We know the IP of our target. So go for the interface. Or actually, we do not need that because we have only one interface available. So go for target and specify our router. So 1.1, and therefore 192.168.1.11. Now it's going to actually spoof that we are the 1.11 guy. So here click Control B and 1. And here we go for the same thing. ARP spoof target 192.168.1.11. 192.168.1.1. So we are now seeing, we are now spoofing that we have the router to that client. Okay, so now here we are main in the middle with that two commands. Now click Control B and C to create new window, and therefore here we can actually use the tools Ferret and Hamster in order to actually capture some cookies. So here just type Ferret, specify the interface, and just wait here. That information we are getting is that we are capturing some packets. Actually, you can see that we have the IP of 1 and the IP of 11, sorry, and the IP of 1 and the MAC addresses. So that means we are capturing some packets. And so now here, go and open another window. And here, just type hamster. And this is the only thing you can do, and you have to do. And just as you can see, the hamster is using some kind of a HTTP proxy on a localhost on that port 1234. So everything will be stored in that HTTP proxy. Every information will be stored there, and we can further extract it. So now we've completely set up our environment, and now it's actual time to go to our Windows machine and start browsing some websites. So open Firefox. Now go for like Stack Overflow. Let's see what's happened here. We have a lot of content going on, a lot of requests. So as you can see, we are capturing the requests. Ferret are actually analyzing it. So we can go for like YouTube.com. We can go and actually see security. Okay. And you see that we have a lot of requests made. Let's go to archive machine. You see all the requests here. Oh, sorry. So let's do them again. Okay. Here. 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 Okay, so you see we have all the requests here again. I've accidentally pressed Ctrl C and terminated the process, but now we start again and generated all of requests again. So let's go and open Firefox and navigate to our proxy. So here in the proxy, just type the proxy server of our hamster, which was localhost. So localhost and 1234. And now we see some interface and we have some targets down below. Now, no clone target, okay, yet. So here we have three targets, 19 databases. We have all the information gathered so far here. And if you press that target, 1.11, we see all available websites with all of their available cookies. So this is how you capture a cookie. This is how you actually perform that kind of attack. First, you become in the middle. Therefore, you actually start tools that are going to analyzing every single packets that fly through us. As you can see, it analyzed every page that we visited. And therefore, extract the cookie from that page. And if you want to see the cookie, just press the cookie button here. You can inspect every request here. So this is how you perform that attack. This is how you can extract information, extract cookies, and see where the victim is actually going and is actually doing. So guys, this is for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed, and thank you everyone for watching.